Yeah, Richard. Oh, okay. Look, I just want to say something about this point about what the council should have done and should do and has done. I mean, soon after this blew up, Ian Ward, as leader of council, made a very good statement. That was very good. But then it went quiet, it went silent. This new statement came out yesterday, I think. It's in the Birmingham Post today, council new statement. I phoned up the Post and I also phoned up the council press room saying, how can I get hold of a copy of this statement so we can spread it around? Nobody could tell me. I don't know if you've got one, Martin, but if you have, I suggest please email it to everybody. Let's get that spread around. But what I'm interested in is what role has the... See, the council's only got one body to talk about education. There's no education committee. There's only an education scrutiny committee, and Martin, you're on it, and so are four other Labour councillors and a couple of Tories. The chair of it, Marion Khan, is actually councillor for Alan Rock, the ward in which Parkfield School is. I haven't seen any statements from the Education Scrutiny Committee. And of course we need dialogue, but we also need the councillors to stand up very clearly and say, we want to defend the kids in that school and the teachers who are under enormous pressure, as well as the parents who want to see a decent kid. So, I wondered what discussion has taken place on the Education Scrutiny Committee about issues, not just now, but issues in general to do with LGBT issues in schools. I looked through the minutes of the last year's meetings. Not one single word could I find on this issue. And the reason for this is because just as the schools' agendas have been so much defined and compressed by government policy, so it's all about testing and so forth, the same thing has happened to the Education Scrutiny Committee in this council. In the past, it had a much wider agenda. It used to talk about these issues that matter to kids in school. Now, almost all it talks about is test results and the statutory requirements like over ensuring there are enough school places and so on. So I think the first thing is there's a lesson to be learnt there by the council and in particular the Education Scrutiny Committee. What could the council do now? Well, it hasn't got any idea what the schools are doing about this issue. Yeah, apart from anecdotal experience and individual experience of council. So the first thing it needs to do is actually carry out an audit of our schools, including the academies. I know they're not council schools, but if the academy shuts its door and says, we're not telling you, publicise it. Yeah. But I think the council needs to carry out an audit of the schools and find out what's going on. What is, for example, happening in the Church of England and Catholic schools about this issue? Can we be confident they're addressing it? Of course we can't. And secondly, it can organise some training for governors. Let's have a meeting like this, but for school governors. So there's a lot of concrete things the council could do. I think the biggest danger, one biggest danger, is it all blows up, yes. But actually there's another big danger, which is that it all blows away. And the schools carry on doing what they're doing. So schools like Anderton Park will carry on doing the excellent work, and many other schools in the city won't touch the issue at all. And it's the kids who pay the price for that. So I think, you know, it reminds me of the struggle around issues of racism and anti-racism in the 70s and 80s. And I think, you know, we need a change of policy by those council members, Jane Francis as well, cabinet member for education, have got to take this on board, not just right now, but for the future and all the schools.